Yeah, they found out that the stone was rolled back, but they also found out that you weren't there anymore. Welcome to the eternal outpouring. I'm going to touch the death, the burial, the resurrection, and ascension you've been through and that you've come out of, and why. Who was watching? Who was praying against you? Why they were praying against you? It was like you've been through a whole movie scene of everybody else watching you play out your downfall. So they thought. I've written down everything that the Lord went through with me today. And I wrote it down so I wouldn't remember anything. He's going to go through the steps that he was bringing you through. And he's also going to illuminate the steps that the world brought you through. Family, friends, manipulators, counterfeits, people that didn't mean you any good, that came in your life for torment or for detour. The death. This is the world. Whether you were brought into addiction, alcoholism, divorce, you might have lost some things along the way. Your home, car went into bankrupt, foreclosure. Things that you took a real toll on. You may have lost a loved one and it really took a major toll on you. Failures that you had to go through. Some of you went through mental illness. Things that, you know, whether you brought it in your life, satanic agents brought it in your life. Remember, the Lord says he has a hope in the future for us. Satan knew about the hope in the future also. Failures. A lot of people watch you with popcorn, watching you go through every time you trip, every time you fell down. Some of you been in jail. Some of you came to the brink of your health where you, it's amazing. It's a miracle that you here. They were watching these things. They were talking about you. They kept their tongue on you. That was the death that they had for you. But on Christ's side, he had you dying to self. Mm-hmm. They didn't know that. But you were dying to your will. You were dying to yourself. He was here all the time. He had his hand over you. Because he knew he was not going to allow Satan to take you out of here. You had to go through what you had to go through because that's where brokenness was coming through. You had to come to the end of yourself. You had to decrease to allow him to come and increase. That was the death. That was the death. Then he brought you through the burial. They brought you through the burial first. This is the burial that they had for you. And like I say, I took my notes. As he spoke, I want to make sure I didn't forget a thing. The burial that they brought you through. They are the ones that threw dirt on you. Slander. Talking about what the death factor that you went through. Mm-hmm. They talked about your downfall. They made sure that everybody knew it. That it was played out. Everybody had an ear to hear. Those that had itching ears. Mm-hmm. They talked about you behind your back like a dog. Well, I'm talking to a multitude because if I wasn't, the Lord wouldn't allow me to make this video. They pretty much spoke your eulogy. They counted you out. You was done for. You was finito. That's what they had. But this was what God was doing. In your burial, God was hiding you. In the hiding you, he was breaking you to make you. He was molding you. He was shaping you. Mm-hmm. He was birthing your mandate in you. Oh yeah, they didn't. This is a season they didn't see from. They didn't see you. They didn't know where you were. I mean, God really had you hidden. You were silent. Probably could have been. For years, this is for this individual or people that I'm talking to, you were hidden for years. You didn't make a sound. Some people even thought you were dead. They didn't know where you were. But God had you hidden so they couldn't beat you down and keep manipulating you. When he has a purpose and a plan, remember, his thoughts are higher than our thoughts. We can never outthink God. God knew how to hide you when to hide you for his purpose and his plan for your life and for his mandate. What an eternal order he was stepping inside of you during the burial. Then your resurrection. See, this way is about to get interesting. This is the way they resurrected. That what they saw when you came up. First thing, you shocked the hell out of people. You left people baffled. You left their mouths wide open because they were wondering, where did you come from? Or they was finding a hard time to believe you were the same person that they buried, that they put to death, that they watched die, that they put the nails in your hand and feet. They did this. You did this. Your generational curses put you there. Life put you in the nails, with the nails in your hands and your feet. But in your resurrection, they saw that you were a new creature in Christ. They saw this with their own eyes. Some of them were still doubting. You know the doubting Thomases. But all you did was walked around with your hands and your feet, showing them the holes where the nails used to be. Glory to God. Yeah, you left a lot of people astonished. They still in shock. That is you. God, why it had to be her? Where'd she come from? I thought I buried her. I thought I killed her. I thought I knocked her out. How is this possible? Just like they saw Jesus walking around. How is it possible? Is it really the Messiah? Is it really Bridget? Is it really you? Come on, y'all. I know y'all can resonate with the Holy Spirit flowing with. But this is what God was doing with his resurrection also. He was raising you from the dead. All that old hurt, pain, unforgiveness you had in your heart, everything that hurt you, that wanted to take you out of here, all that suppression, depression, oppression, you clean, you clear, you're free. The resurrection. Oh, yeah. See, now you're set free. And who's the Son set free is free indeed. That's what the resurrection brought. See, in the resurrection, now they know who you are. Now they know who sent you, who walks with you. Yeah, they can see you. They can see you. Now we step into the ascension. Glory to glory to glory to glory to glory to God. Now we step into the ascension. The ascension. This is where God is raising up you in the sight of your enemies. All those that slandered you. All those that had something to say about your downfall. That you are a renegade. That you would never be amount to nothing. Oh, they just gonna go, but they gonna stay in addiction. They ain't gonna never come out of there. They ain't gonna never get clean and free. They ain't gonna never be this. They ain't gonna never be that. They're out of there. But see, they see the proof of your ascension. They know that God is walking with you. And not only God, the entourage of the third heaven stands with you, in you, and all of way around you. You can open your mouth and there goes the ascension of legislative orders being written in the heavenlies, in the third heaven, and what you speak becomes manifested power in the earth. They know that God is with you. They know that you are the apple of his eye. Remember you? The addict, the ex-alcoholic, the mentally ill, the downtrodden, the one who lost everything, and they was laughing at you. But look at you now. God has set a table in the presence of your enemies. And everyone that had their tongue on you got to eat every word. That's what he said. He's going to make sure that in your uprising, your ascension, the only way they're going to find you is by looking up. And this is not gloating. This is God raising you from the dead when everybody else counted you out. And yet here you are, consistently manifesting his glory, making his name great in the earth. Yes. It's a beautiful thing when you know that Abba Father, Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit, that when they saw you back then, when you was messed up and people were burying you and they counted you out, he watched you and he waited. He waited on you. God waited on you. Abba Father waited on you. Because he knew, as much of a renegade as you was out there for Satan, in the streets, in the darkness, you was going to bust, hell wide open on the in the kingdom of God. And you are tearing down the witchcraft now. You are tearing disorder. You are unveiling. And they are scared of you because now you walk in truth. You are truth. And they just back up. They watch everybody watch you. They may not like your content. They may not comment. But you can best believe their eye is constantly on you. God bless you, my kings and queens, for the things you came out of. You keep sowing. You keep moving in the things of God. There's nothing to look backwards for. We in forward movement. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Continue forward. Full throttle. I love you. God bless you. I pray you like and subscribe the videos. Share the video, because if it's not for you, I can guarantee you it's for someone you know. Keep prospering. You ascended. In Jesus' name, amen.